Hey Run Junkies, a couple of weeks ago I promised to give you my final impressions on my Dopey Challenge experience, how I felt my training went, how I learned some lessons through the process, and what I feel about the final result. So the Train Like a Mother Club released this 26-week training plan for the Dopey Challenge, along with some very informative podcasts from the Train Like a Mother Club. Hundreds of half and full marathon runners are using these heart rate training plans and are getting tremendous results. They're shattering PRs and running injury free. But that wasn't the case with me. Every runner is different, as is every plan. We figure out what works for us and what doesn't, and we adjust accordingly. The heart rate training plans, Coach Mary Catherine Fleming, and the whole Train Like a Mother Club team put together an amazing set of resources, and I do believe it's a great value. Since you are looking at one data point, which is your heart rate, it is important to know that warmer weather and sunlight affects your heart rate even if your training effort remains the same. For obvious reasons, caffeine increases your heart rate, so if you are like me and love your coffee, you might want to wait until after your morning run before that first cup of joe. In addition, sleep and stress and nutrition all affect your heart rate, so in order for me to gain anything out of this training plan, I had to change my whole morning routine. Before heart rate training, I would get up, have my first cup of coffee, and then get my son out of bed. After I sent him to school, I would go for my run. Well, during heart rate training, in order for me to gather consistent data, I was getting up at 4:30 every morning so I could get my run finished before I got my son out of bed, and then I could have my coffee. It was a long 7 months. On the positive side, I never got injured, but I've never really been prone to running injury anyway, so I'm not sure if that was much of a consideration for me. In the end though, I determined that this method of training is not sustainable for me long term. I'm not able to maintain that routine and that schedule, mostly due to life circumstances. In addition, I am not at all happy with any of my Dopey times. I was very disappointed that this training plan had not prepared me for faster race days. Not that I was looking to PR or anything, but I was hoping to be out there for less time. I did learn some things from this training method though that I will carry forward into the next year of training. First, I learned what an easy run really is. Running in zones 1 or 2 or below 140 or whatever method you happen to be using is, and this is a huge understatement, very hard to do. I used to think that my easy runs before heart rate training had to come in around an 11-minute mile, but now they fall between 13 and 15-minute miles. That is what easy means. Keeping those runs easy also means I can run 5 days a week without risking injury and still maintaining that endurance. Another thing I learned was time on your feet makes a huge difference when you show up to the Dopey Challenge. Not only did I do a lot of running, 5 days a week of running up to 40 miles a week at one point, I was also doing 15 miles of walking a week. The running is important, but adding the afternoon and evening walks are extremely helpful in those back-to-back running events. So as part of that 6-hour marathon, my feet never hurt because I spent so much time on my feet during training. So final thoughts about heart rate training. Is it a good method of training? Yes, absolutely. Is it for everyone? I'm not gonna answer that. I am gonna say it's not for me. I do think it's worth looking at and trying before you make that judgment for yourself. Just because I didn't have success doesn't mean that you won't. In fact, I'm leaving a link in the description below to the Train Like a Mother Club, and they have a ton of new plans out for spring. So please check them out. They are worth a look. Again, many of my peers have had tremendous success with the heart rate training plans, and I think it's worth a look, especially if you are a novice runner and you want to try for a longer distance event, or if you are consistently sidelined by injury and you just need to make a change. Paying close attention to the one metric of heart rate data is simply not enough for me. I like to look at kind of a broader picture of heart rate and pace and how I'm feeling and take all of that into consideration. But now let's look at the coming year and how my training plan is very full. As I mentioned in previous videos, I have hired a coach Christine Hinton, who has done some work with the Another Mother Runner tribe. Now, what I'm about to show you, what's happening over the next year, I would not attempt on my own without hiring a coach. Let's go to the whiteboard. The way I see it, I can break this year down into two parts, or maybe even a box. First target is the Boulder 10K in May. I am hoping to PR this race, but since I'm using it as proof of time for the Avengers races in November, I'm really just happy with a solid effort. The next race on the calendar is not technically on the calendar yet, but I have some ideas. Sometime in the late summer, early fall, I wanna do a 10 miler or a half marathon to use as proof of time for Dopey, which means that the next 7 or 8 months, I will be focusing primarily on increasing my speed. So once I submit those proof of times for Avengers and Dopey, then I can switch gears a little bit, hopefully maintaining a little bit of that speed, but really focusing on the back-to-back time on your feet runs. First two-thirds of the year, I will be focusing on increasing speed, but the second third of the year and into the first part of 2018, I will be focusing more on the endurance piece of it and the back-to-back running events. The new training plan is in effect and I'm already enjoying it. I am having a blast with this new plan. But before I go today, I wanna ask you if you've ever tried heart rate training, and if so, what was your experience? Did you find success or not so much? Please leave your comments and tell your story in the box below. If you like this video, give me that thumbs up. That is it from me today. Thank you so much for watching. Get out there, go find your awesome. We'll see you next time. And until then, happy running.